How to make your iPhone read to you. Did you know that you can have your iPhone read Kindle books out loud to you? In this video, I'm gonna walk you through the step-by-step process I use to get my iPhone to read out loud to me. Stay tuned. Hey, it's Brian Dixon, and you are watching The Advanced Show, your daily pep talk to help you crush it at work and step it up at home. With the advent of ebook publishing, it is amazing the quality and the quantity of ebooks that you can get on very niche topics. In fact, the perfect book to help you with that exact business problem you are facing right now is available in the Kindle store. But what busy leader has time to sit and read anymore? I might have 30 minutes a day to sit down and read, but I am in the car a lot, and reading in the car is dangerous. So not only will this tip help you get more reading done, but it's also gonna save lives. You're welcome. Normally, I just open my Kindle app on my iPhone. Here's an amazing book called Everything I Know by Paul Jarvis. He's a genius web developer, and there's a lot that I can learn from him, but I don't have the time to sit down and read his Kindle book.
Sorry, Paul.
Instead, I use the accessibility feature on my iPhone to have the book read to me. Here's the step-by-step.
Open Settings, click on General, go to Accessibility, click on VoiceOver, and turn it on.
VoiceOver on.
VoiceOver on.
You are now in the land of VoiceOver, and your iPhone just became its super mutant cousin. Click back to the home screen.
Click on Kindle twice.
Kindle, menu off.
And now I just take two fingers and do a swipe.
Introduction, I'm afraid of being arrested by the creative police. They'll receive an urgent tip that I'm to be immediately brought up on fraud charges. They'll break through the front door of my house and drag me kicking and screaming, more like sobbing uncontrollably, from my bed. I'll be tried in a court of my peers, home, Kindle.
How cool is that? So you can get your Kindle app on your iPhone to read to you. Amazing, right? Here are three quick tips that I learned to make this process pretty painless. First, drag your Kindle app icon to the home screen. Two, turn off all notifications. And three, don't try to multitask. This will just cause major frustration. VoiceOver really changes the way that your iPhone works, so don't think you can just hop back and forth between Kindle and Twitter and email. It will start reading everything to you, which is weirder than it sounds. And now for a bonus tip. For you super techies out there, you can plug your iPhone into an external recorder and create your own MP3 version of the Kindle audiobook. Then, just import this into iTunes and now you can multitask, especially if you use the Swift app, which I review in a video right over here. If that tips over your head, just pretend that I never mentioned it. And of course, this is only for personal use. Don't create the audiobook and post it online or share it with friends. Make sure the author gets paid. Did I go way too fast? Well, I created a step-by-step blog post at theadvancedshow.com. Just click on the link below or visit theadvancedshow.com/myiphonereadstome. Yep, that's the link. If you are ready to take your life and your work to the next level, you need to check out my Life Work course. Click this button right over here to watch a free webinar outlining my 7 productivity tips for busy leaders. Do you want to be notified when I post a new video? Just click on the subscribe button right up here. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure that you leave a note in the comments if it helped you out.
I won't say it.
But what?
It's like,
To watch this door.